Transmission begins.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
This is the Josh Tolley Show on the GCN Radio Network.
Anyway, Rio, the Olympics are coming. Rio de Janeiro. How sexually deprived or weird or perverted or... just get a load of this story. The Olympics are coming up, and 450,000 condoms will be distributed to the Olympians. How much sex are these people having? And aren't they competing in games while they're there? Don't they have something important to do? Are they really having so much? What is this, the sex Olympics? I mean, seriously. So they're distributing over 450,000 condoms and 175,000 packets of lube. And I understand some of you might be teaching homeschool class right now, and that was a little bit of an adult topic, but this is that we need to talk about this. The International Olympic Committee says that the condoms would encourage 10,000 athletes and staff to practice safe sex. Wait a second. Wait. Let's just do the real math here. Let's think about this just for a moment, shall we? We have 450,000 condoms divided by 10,500 staff. That means everybody's going to have sex 43 times during this 13-day contest. Are you serious? This is beyond me. Oh, yeah, I get it. We're only here for 2 weeks. But while you're here for 2 weeks, have sex 43 times. Evidently with strangers who you're not married to, because we need to have all this safe sex stuff. How about we just say, hey, guess what? You're here to compete in the Olympics. What are you doing having sex with everybody in the Olympic Village? But this isn't new. During London Games, they did the same thing. During Russia's Games, they did the same thing. They've been supplying over 150,000 condoms per Olympics ever since 2000. Well, now it's up to 450,000 of them. Good golly molly. I mean, don't we have something else to do during the Olympics, like compete? Are you having this much sex outside of the Olympics? Like, why do you really want to go to the Olympics? To get a gold medal or the gold condom? Like, what's the purpose of going? I don't get it. And I'm not trying to be a prude, but holy Hannah. 450,000 condoms divided by 10,500 athletes. That's 43 times you're having sex in a 2 week period with total strangers. So what do? Wake up, train a little bit, go have sex, train a little bit more, go have sex, compete in your contest, and then go have sex again? This is just... And then we wonder, don't we? We wonder, well, why can't we have good candidates? It's related to this. It really is. Because your entire belief system is an overtone of everything else. Your entire belief system is an overtone of non-aggression principles. Your entire belief system is an overtone of currency exchange. These things are related. Well, that's and exactly what we were told is going to happen is happening. We're getting to this place where evil is called good, good is called evil. And then you're criticized for having morals. How dare you, Josh? How dare you criticizing me for having sex 43 times in 2 weeks with total strangers? How dare you, Josh? I'm an adult. I didn't say I had to make it illegal. I'm not trying to pass a law. I'm just saying you're an idiot. You have a complete freedom to be an idiot. You have complete freedom to say, yep, I'm going to totally be stupid. But I still also have the freedom to say, hey, the spread of stupidity is the reason why we're falling as a not only a nation, but as a planet. And what happened to coaches telling their athletes, no sex before a competition? Boxers, you know, your boxing coaches, you say, hey, even your wife, stay away from your wife for a week before this. Well, now it's, you know, go compete, but hurry up, run faster, not to win, but to hurry up and go back and have sex. We'll be back right after this. Hey, thanks for watching. If you loved what I had to say, then subscribe right here. If you hated what I had to say, subscribe right here. It's fun being mad on social media, isn't it? Either way, I'd love to hear from you. Send me an email right there.